Well, Australians under 35 will be able to live and work in the UK more easily after Scott Morrison agreed to a landmark trade agreement with Great Britain. But the deal comes with a compromise, with British backpackers in Australia no longer required to do farm work as part of their visa. For more, let's bring in Acting Prime Minister Michael McCormack in Canberra. Good morning to you. Thanks for your time this
morning.
Who are the big winners and are we the losers?
Well, the big winners are Australian producers, Australian farmers, indeed Australians, full stop. Carl, this could mean $1.3 billion of boost to the economy. And indeed, with sheep meat, I just noticed you had a woolly beast there. There's going to be indeed 25,000 tonnes of lamb chops and others have free and duty-free access to the UK market right now. Potentially 68 million customers bidding for Australia's wonderful chops, wonderful sheep meat, but beef as well, sugar, all of those tariffs, immediate access to duty-free access to UK markets, and eventually over a period of between 8 and 10 years for those agricultural commodities, there won't be any tariffs at all.
So given the situation right now, how is an Aussie producer going to be benefiting more from this deal as opposed to the last?
Well, it's more access to more markets. So with beef, 35,000 tonnes of beef will be going into the UK market, potentially ramping up to 110,000 tonnes over an 8-year period, and for duty-free access. Sheep meat, 25,000 to 75,000 tonnes, and immediate access for dairy, cheeses, for sugar, 80,000 tonnes. They're big numbers, and so that's going to be great for the, say, casino beef producers, the Junee lamb producers, indeed the Mackay sugar growers.
Here's the problem that I foresee. This morning already, there's blowback from some of the Scottish beef producers, some of the Walsh beef producers, some of the Northern Ireland beef producers. This is by no means a done deal, is it?
I'm not so worried about those ones you mentioned. I'm always concerned, and I always put Australians first. And I'm worried and concerned about Australian producers. I want what's best for them, Carl. And so when we diversify our markets...
No, but what I'm saying is that there's no guarantee the deal is going to be done, that he may have so much domestic pressure that he doesn't sign off on that.
Ah, well, Boris Johnson and Scott Morrison had a very, very good conversation at number 10. I know they had a conversation over some lamb chops. They, our PM gave him a packet of Tim Tams. That should be enough to clinch any deal, Carl.
Well, three wishes with it. Look, we've still got a problem with workers, don't we, in the ag sector. What are you going to be doing to plug that gap now that it's not one of the provisos of getting a visa here?
So, secondary to this deal and separate from this arrangement, we've got an ag visa deal in place. We're going to have, by quarter three of this year, a farmer access for the ASEAN countries, for those South Pacific, those Australian and Asian countries in that rim. We're going to be able to have access to many workers who would otherwise not be able to have free and unfettered access. We're going to be making sure there's more flexibility for the ASEAN nations, banking on and doubling up with what we're doing in the South Pacific at the moment. So this is good. David Littleproud, the Agriculture Minister, will be working with those countries to make sure that that ag visa is in place by quarter three this year.
Okay, so that's
we've got 67,500 jobs in regional Australia at the moment, Carl. They're not just in farming, they're in all areas of endeavour. And I say again, if people want a lifestyle like no other, look to the regions.
Okay, so what you're saying this morning is new, though. In this interview, you're saying that there'll be a deal done on ag visas later on this year. How many people will that involve? What sort of countries are we talking about?
Oh, that could involve any number of people. So what we're doing is we're providing more flexible arrangements. Those deals will be worked through. Those arrangements will be put in place. I know David Littleproud has been working hard on this, as we all have, as the government, to ensure that our farms have the workforce that they need and when they need. And there's many, many jobs going in regional Australia at the moment, not just on farms, but in accountancy practices, law firms. Great place. Big enough in which to get a good cup of coffee, small enough to care, Carl. I always say it.
You haven't jumped the gun on another announcement, have you, Deputy?
No, not at all. This is being worked through, and happy to say that, well, if you want to say you've got an exclusive, well done to you, Carl, but this has been worked through for some time.
Yeah.
I know that it's a significant part of what we're doing as far as making sure that we've got the labour in the right place at the right time. These farmers, you go anywhere throughout regional Australia, Carl, they're crying out for people.
They sure are. Just finally, the Tamil family reunited in Perth overnight. They've been asked to leave Christmas Island for years. You've had a change of heart on that. What are you thinking about their future? Do you support them being able to go back to Bilawila? Because an awful lot of national voters believe so.
Well, look, I understand this, and the situation is very difficult. These emotive issues are never easy, and I know that Alex Hawke, the Immigration Minister, has made a determination, as he should yesterday, to ensure that the family has been reunited. They have got full access to health, to schools, to all the things that Australians would expect. But they are going through a legal process, so we'll let that court process run its course, and we'll see what happens from there.
OK, good to talk to you. Thanks for your time.
Good on you, Carl.
Appreciate it. Ali.
All the best.